and welcome to Aloha Authentic. I'm your host, Kamaka Pili. On today's show, we're here at Kauai Museum to learn about the unconquered kingdom of Kauai and Niʻihau. Interesting fact, the island of Kauai stands as the oldest of the main Hawaiian islands at approximately 5 million years old. Did you know? Now you do. It is my complete honor to introduce the executive director of this beautiful space, Kauai Museum, Uncle Chucky Boy Chock. Thank you very much,
Mahalo.
Uncle. Really
Thank
appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you. Ka alele lai te lewa, ho o wili wili ka iwa o ke alohi, ki e ka ua ka lepa, ho nene ka uhulu nehu, ha anehu nehu ka lawai, ka aloa I tau lumano, no ke kanikala au au I ole ka, ua lohea mai la iuka. U haulani ka lele vai o maka wili wili. Maka pūnana ala au vahine ali. Aloha.
Beautiful. Oh, this is gonna be an awesome show. Before we get into that, thank you very much for sharing that, Uncle. We have our protocol, our umeke, our bowl of poi is open on the table. Because Tutu used to always say, you know, when the bowl of poi is open on the dinner table, we don't speak negative because that energy will then spoil the food. And in essence, we don't want to spoil the show. I do want to give a highlight to Himea Ona Poi for sponsoring our poi today. Uncle, mahalo for the oli. That was beautiful.
Oh, no, mahalo.
I do want to ask, you know, just in essence, actually, first, we tend to hear the name Kauai the most frequent when we're talking about this island, but I come across more poetic, more longer names, and in essence, for this island, I hear Mano Kalani Po a lot.
Oh, like many of the other islands, Moko Keawe, Big Island, Pi'ilani, Mahui, O Kahele Lani, Iho.
O Ahu Kakuhi Hewa, O
Ahu Ai, Mano Kalani Po, Kauai.
So where does that come from? What is the name all about?
Mano Kalani Po was the son of Kukona in the 1400s. He was known as a really energetic and a chief of great wisdom.
Awesome.
And you know, there was the battle of Kawelewele, which, thanks to him, he won that battle when the four chiefs came here in the 1400s.
So long ago. And the beautiful thing is here at Kauai Museum, you capture, I mean, just looking around this place, you capture a lot of that history to continue to be perpetuated, and it becomes more of a living history in here. Can I just ask, when we speak of Kauai and when we speak of Niʻihau, there's such a sense of pride. To sure. you, what is that pride of Kauai and Niʻihau?
The sense of pride really is telling the story, really, of our ali'i, that for many, many years, no one ever knew Kaumu ali'i, the basics, you know, mm-hmm. the last ali'i aimoku of Kauai and Niʻihau. And even his mom, Kamaka Hele, that's a great story in itself, just to hear. But so we get to share that with all our kids, our keiki here on Kauai. And so now when you ask them who was the last ruling ali'i aimoku over here on Kauai, they all will say Kaumu ali'i.
With a beautiful statue standing outside of this museum.
Yes. And Deborah Kapuleo, Kikai Ha'akulou, her birth name. Yes.
Beautiful. You know, what I think is fascinating about Kauai is that it's, as we mentioned on the top of the show, the oldest island, but I would have to say, if not the one of the least known about islands. So if there's anything specific about Kauai today that you would want people to know about, what would that be?
Well, there are many things. But okay, right at the top of my head, I'll just say the Garden Island. You know, we're the same size as Oahu. There's a million people there, and we have 70,000 here. It's a big garden, you know, just that. But also, what's also special is, if you go back pre-contact, the Oahu. The Oahu celebration took place only on Kauai.
What is that?
It's when the birth of a chief or the celebration of an elevation of an ali'i, and it was taken where they create what the firebrand with papala kepau, the wood of the hau, and that was our fireworks. So they would climb up to Makana, check with our kahuna or the kahuna nui to see if it was the right winds for this moment. And he would say, when it's time to toss the firebrand off of the cliff, off of the mountain. And the beauty to that is you wanted to be there. Can you imagine this? Hundreds and hundreds of va'a or canoe there with people waiting for the embers, hopefully touches their skin. Why? Because the mana.
Wow.
And the beauty to that, can you imagine we're there like, I got it. You
know? See this mark? See this mark?
Yeah, that's right. It was the mana.
That's beautiful. Yeah. When we talk about Kauai, we have to also mention Niʻihau. What is the relationship and how did that relationship come to bind these two islands to be, I guess, lack of a better term, sister, brother,
sure,
sibling
sure.
islands?
Today we are one, but it wasn't always that way. It was in the 17th century when Kaʻeakulani was ruler of half of Niʻihau and the other was Kauai Hoa. So it was a north ruler and a south of the island ruler. So it was time really to have one ruler. So they had a battle, but what Kaʻeakulani did was called his brothers from Maui. You know, he's a Maui chief, Pi'ilani, right? Kekaulike, all of that warriors. You know, at the time, that's where the great warriors came from. So they came here and they had a battle with Kauai Hoa, and the obvious was they overtook him and became under one rule, which was Kaʻeakulani. And that's when we became one. And that's when everything became pono. Mm. And today, it's always Kauai Niʻihau.
And then we fast forward to today, Niʻihau is a privately owned island with limited access, really just for those who come from the island.
Absolutely, and it'll be like that forever.
Yeah.
Well, kudos to the Robinsons.
Do you mind if I dive deeper into Niʻihau after we come back from the break?
Oh, it'd be an honor.
Awesome. So stick around, we'll have more of this very delicious conversation right after the break, right here on Aloha Authentic. Welcome back to Aloha Authentic. Welcome back to the beautiful Kauai Museum here on the Garden Isle. And Uncle, one more time, thank you very much. So far, the conversation has been so ono, as we would say. But I do want to just kind of pick off where you mentioned that you believe Niʻihau would be privately owned forever. Why do you say that?
I think the important component to that is because the traditions will stay alive, will stay, you know. The lifestyle of the Niʻihauans will stay. Once they eat ice cream at McDonald's, they don't want to go back, right? But it's their language. Oh boy, you know they continue to speak that way even when they move off island. Mm-hmm. They continue.
And for those who are familiar, that's more with the T sounds and that type of dialect.
Yes.
How did Niʻihau become privately owned in the first place?
Mrs. Sinclair purchased that. And when she did that, at Robinson's and Sinclair's, right? She made sure that it stayed Niʻihau. Mm-hmm. You know, there's no outside influences whatsoever. They continue to do what they've always done.
Yeah, and I always think, because, you know, I think some other people may have opinions about that being privately owned, but as you mentioned, I think if they were influenced by outside influence, that they may have been just as changed as all the other islands. So the fact that that is literally like a step into yesteryear.
Oh, absolutely. And you know, I'm always very protective of Niʻihau personally when they say, you know, we cannot go fishing over there, you know. But we have to keep that place. That's their refrigerator, mm-hmm. you know. And
I see you have your beautiful Niʻihau lei.
Oh, mahalo to Mama Ane.
And I have mine from Uncle Kele Kanahele.
Mother and son.
Yeah. Beautiful man, a beautiful family.
Oh, amen.
So, you know, you mentioned this in the first segment, Kamaka Pili, the mother of Kaumualii.
Aye.
When we speak of women in power, we don't necessarily see too many pictures, hear too many stories, because I think especially in Hawaii and chiefs and rulers, we tend to think King Kamehameha first. But in terms of women, how powerful were women in ancient Hawaii?
Let's put it this way, she was.
She,
she ruled Kauai and Niʻihau for 24 years.
Like ruler.
Ruler. She was the ali'i here. From 1770 to 1794,
wow.
to be exact. And no other ali'i could say that as far as wahine.
Wow.
Yeah.
So when we, you know, then we talk about her, but we also, as you mentioned, King Kaumualii being the last Ali'i Aimoku ruling chief of this island, that really then brings us to this separate kingdom conversation. When we speak of separate kingdom, what really is that talking about?
Oh,
the unconquered kingdom in the other way.
My favorite platform. You know, I can take you back to the 1400s.
Please do.
You know, when Kukona was the ruler, Manukalanipo's daddy, Papa. And the funny thing is, he was known for an Ali'i that loved to take naps. So this is a true story. Anyway, he gets word from his advisors, or the kahuna nui says, sort of like this, hey, chief, there's going to be a battle. And it's all his kukona says to his advisors, so what's the outcome? Ah, lana kila. So in his mind, okay, victory. Time comes, a few months later, what took place was the big island chief, Kalaunui Ohua, decides he wants to conquer all the islands. And it sounds familiar. Big island goes to Maui, they battle, they decide to merge. Go to Molokai, cross Molokai, Oahu, yeah. Now it's time to come here. When they come here, here's what father says to son, Manukalanipo. Ah, you got the plan? And this is the gist, right? And Manukalanipo says, yes, dad. He says, okay. He tells the advisor, tell me when they're here. Sure enough, they're on their way. Hundreds of canoes from all the islands. Now, it's four islands against Kauai. Try to do the math, right? You do the math. But when they come here, Kukona says to Manukalanipo, are you ready? He says, yes, dad. He says, okay, I'm going to take a nap. Let me know when the battle is over. Simple as that. Exactly what took place. Far and few, just short, I'll tell you, put it in a nutshell. They come here. The four chiefs is down in a place called Keoniloa area, somewhere down there. Keoniloa, some people call it shipwrecks. And the plan was to lure all the warriors into Waiawa. But they said, Waiawa, Waiawa. Hayava, you'll be here. They lure them there, and guess what? While the battle is going on, they capture the four chiefs, Kauai. Game over. Brrr. Football game over. The war is done. And word gets to Manukalanipo, end the battle. And here's what dad says. Kukona says to the son, mend the wounded and send them home to their respected islands. Mm. It's not the norm. And bury the dead. Not the norm again.
Respect.
Yeah.
And respect.
But he tells the four chiefs, you will stay here. Sort of kind of like a house arrest. About a year and a half later is when he decides to send them home. Now it's time for them to go home. Really good story.
So, Uncle, just to paint a picture, when we hear about King Kamehameha and his conquest, this happened way after these stories you're talking about.
400 years.
Wow, gosh, that just means Kauai and Niʻihau has been victorious battle over battle. Do you mind sharing more about the inclusion of the Hawaiian Kingdom coming up after the break?
Be very humble, too.
Awesome. Stick around. We'll learn more about the Hawaiian Kingdom and its establishment. Coming up right here on Aloha Authentic. What do you think the purpose of these objects were? Was it A, implements, B, weapons, C, instruments, or D, tools? The answer when we return. What do you think the purpose of this object was? The answer is B, weapon. Hawaiians made a variety of weapons used for different strategies. Clubs, known as neva, could be fashioned from the natural roots or limb segments of a tree. Pikoi, or whirling weights, are a different type of weapon that was excellent for offensive attacks. It's made using a knobbed stone head connected to a long piece of cordage. Pikoi made great concealed weapons that could be used for forceful, accurate blows. Alternatively, a warrior could run towards an opponent and whirl the pikoi to catch his legs or body in order to throw him off balance. Did you know? Now you do. Welcome back to Aloha Authentic, and once again, welcome back to Kauai Museum. And we're learning about now, Uncle, if we could talk about the Hawaiian Kingdom. You know, we hear about Kamehameha and his conquer through battle as he's making his way up from Hawaii Island through what we know as Maui County today, Maui, Molokai, Lanai, Oahu. But it's a different story when we come to Kauai and Niʻihau, and that's where the unconquered portion comes from as well. How did Niʻihau and Kauai become part and really finalize and establish officially the Hawaiian Kingdom?
Well, after the second attempt was, you know, it was a failure on part of Kamehameha, but it wasn't his fault. It really was. Cholera just went rampant on Oahu, you know, and so they all, more than half of his warriors died because of that. And at the that's when it was, I think we all believe that he came to his this place where, you know, he probably spoke to his advisors and said, what must I do? And it's make peace with Kauai. On Kauai's side, Kaumualii always wanted peace, because if you do the math, it was 100-1 here. Our people would have been slaughtered. It's like Liliʻu, save our people. He always had that in mind. We could never win, you know, it's like a punahou against, you know what I mean? Kailua High School.
Punahou, Kamehameha, St. Louis.
But it was, but what I'm saying is, we were always outnumbered, and it was pretty obvious. And the bottom line for Kaumualii, he always wanted peace.
So what was this, or how did this peaceful inclusion?
Once they became, they trusted each other, because they didn't trust each other. They went back and forth. But once they came at that place, then the contingent from Kauai, Kaumualii and his entourage boarded the ship that was sent over by Kamehameha, and they all went over. And it took place at Pakaka in 1810, the peace talks. You know, putting it in a nutshell, Kaumualii said, my people, what's in it is yours, you know, and so forth. And Kamehameha says, no, your people, what's in it, you keep, and you continue to rule. I think that was so important that Kamehameha said to Kaumualii, you continue to rule. And that was beautiful. And I don't think his warriors agreed with that.
Really?
No, not at all.
But so what you're talking about is more like a kingdom within a kingdom, like how we have a nation within a nation. Yes. Like you're ruled by Kamehameha, but you are still the ruler of these islands.
Yes, Kaumualii was the only one.
And why do you say you think his warriors didn't
agree? It was known that they wanted Kaumualii dead. It was known, but here's what happened, right? Word got to Isaac Davis, said to Kaumualii, who was an advisor to Kamehameha, and he said to Kaumualii, because they befriended each other, and he said, kind of like this, Rada, don't eat the food. Kaumualii, he left. He left.
Because they went poison the food.
In history, that night, Isaac Davis died. That's why we honor him in the painting.
Wow. So all of this, as mentioned at the beginning of the show, you capture a lot of these stories, and they're all throughout these different exhibits here at Kauai Museum.
Yeah.
How are you so successful in this establishment, in these stories? We were talking before we filming that the Smithsonian came down here many times and acknowledging this museum.
Pre-COVID.
So why do you think Kauai Museum has been so successful in sharing these mo'olelo?
I don't know how to gauge success, but I do know that the word was getting out beyond Hawaii of this small institution that it's kind of jewel of the ocean, you know, the Pacific, right? You know, and so we were gaining momentum until COVID came. But with that said, the floodgates have opened now. And so we continue to enhance what we're doing, but at the same time, we continue to tell the Kauai Ali'i story, because it's so important. And all the islands should be doing that, and I think they are now.
And just going back, I think when we think of a lot of rulers, ali'i, we always just tend to think of Kamehameha. But to note, not all families are agreeance in the mo'olelo and the pride or the, you know, the fluff that everybody gives Kamehameha.
Well, I think it's human nature, right? We only want to hear the good things of our ali'i, because there are things, because all the ali'i had their flaws, right? So, and by human nature, we want to hear just the good stuff. We don't want to hear the back stories that the place, like, what?
Kind of. But in here, I'd have to say, everybody needs to visit here, because between the paintings, which you guys have beautiful paintings, but we have our Niʻihau shells and exhibits, and you guys have so many different exhibits that it just seems to capture that pride that we mentioned at the top of the show.
Yeah, I mean, you hit it on the head. I don't know how to elaborate on that, but it was by design, and it is what the visitors wanted. And the blueprint of what we have now came from the comment sheets. And it is what it is now. And
it is what it is.
Yeah, you know, we're just honored to tell the Niʻihau Kauaʻi story.
Well, thank you very much for sharing it here on Aloha Authentic.
Oh, this was so
awesome. Stick around, we'll be right back on Aloha Authentic. Welcome back to Aloha Authentic, and Uncle Chucky Boy, I cannot thank you enough. This is not to the extent that you have shared with us, but a little makana and appreciation and gratitude for what you have shared.
No, mahalo, and thank you for sharing Kauai with your audience.
You know, I'm hoping that people would want to come down here, which I think they will now, but if they want to plan their trip here, where can they go to find out more about Kauai Museum?
Just go on the website, it's kauaimuseum.org.
Awesome, thank you very much, Uncle. Our featured artists for this episode, we're highlighting the company Treehouse Teas. Treehouse Teas is a boutique tea company that utilizes 100% of Hawaii-grown teas and botanicals in all their products. They source directly from small family farms on the island of Hawaii, Oahu, and Maui. Be sure to visit their website and social media handles to find out more. And if you aren't already doing so, be sure to follow us, Aloha Authentic, on our social media platforms as well. Great conversations to come. Once again, Uncle, mahalo nui loa.
Mahalo.
Aloha.
Aloha.
Ahui ho.